I am now en route to Pittsburgh for Steel City Comic Con. I have never done the show before. I have no idea if I'll sell out, but I'm going to give it my all. I will make every hour of this show count. Only I can get SOON SHIN to surpass 100,000 sales and beyond. I am as prepared for this fight as I can be. Over the course of this convention, I'm going to learn a great deal, and I'm taking you along for the ride with me. Together, we will discover how steel sharpens steel. No matter how much I prepare for a convention, I am never going to be 100% certain of the outcome. But one thing is certain, I will never stop putting myself out there. The opening hour of Steel City Comic Con was off to a pretty rough start, but if I want to break 100,000 sales at this show, then I need to hold my ground. I couldn't help but reflect throughout the course of this weekend all the events that led up to this moment. I remember when I was a 6-year-old kid and realized after having read my first comic from cover to cover that this is what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. My dream of having a full-time career in comics was always met with severe criticism. I was constantly discouraged and scrutinized, and I don't regret any of it. It all made me stronger. All my naysayers have long since been proven wrong. The only person I have to prove anything to now is myself. The business of Comic-Con is a very brutal sport. Every rejection, every scoff, and every negative encounter hurts, but I'm beyond that pain now. I don't care about rejection. All I care about is getting people excited about SOON SHIN. And because that is my focus, I cannot lose. When it comes to my work, I am mentally indestructible. I forced myself through that rejection, and the first day ended magnificently. I sold over 300 books and made a significant dent in my graphic novel inventory. I was exactly where I needed to be. Day two was off to a solid start, but then things slowed down to a drastic halt in the afternoon, and once again, I found myself reflecting as I stood in the near-empty aisles. I always knew that I had to be relentless in my pursuit of glory. I never once relied on anything but my own actions. When I fell, I forced myself back to my feet quickly in order to stay in the fight. That was the only way for me to prove that I had the grit to stay in this game for the long haul. I don't believe I have succeeded. I believe that I'm in a perpetual state of failure, but have now learned how to recover quickly and how to smash past it. By the end of the second day, I had already sold enough books to put SOON SHIN over 100,000 sales. But there was no way I was going to sell out, and I wasn't sure how I felt about that. What happened that evening changed my entire philosophy of doing conventions, and I owe it all to my good pal, Ted Sikora, who has not only been on this show as a guest in the past, but is the creator of the independent sensations of Apama and Tap Dance Killer. Ted and I have been doing shows together for a while now, and we've become brothers in arms. On Saturday, we went out to dinner to celebrate a great day on the show floor, at which point he revealed to me that he loves the challenge of a new show. I was shocked to hear this from him because I usually like having an idea of what my odds are, but I understood the logic to his thinking. That is, after all, what has made this crazy journey of comics so worthwhile. The fact that nothing ever is, or ever will be certain. The only reason that Ted, myself, and all the other creators we know and love are able to do this is because we were never afraid to venture off to the unknown. It was never a fantasy for us. It was always reality. It is because of Ted that I decided to do Steel City Comic Con in the first place. And as much as I was hoping to sell out now that I had surpassed 100,000 sales, I decided not to think about it anymore and to just focus on engaging new readers and getting as much from this show as I possibly could. In total, I sold over 1,000 books at this show. I anticipated selling somewhere around 900, but managed to surpass my own expectations. Of the 1,100 books I brought with me, less than 100 remained unsold. That is a victory. Breaking 100,000 sales is a milestone, but it is not my ultimate goal. There are still millions of people out there who have yet to learn about SOON SHIN, and I will reach them. no matter the hardships that stand in my way. I will get my book out there, and I will never fear the unknown. What Ted helped me to realize has no doubt made me stronger. Steel sharpens steel. Like I said before, I learned more from the shows I don't sell out at than the ones that I do. And the fact that I didn't sell out this weekend is only going to make my next sellout all that much sweeter. I'll definitely return to Steel City Comic Con in the future. And to all my new friends in the Pittsburgh area, thank you for helping my series reach this incredible milestone. And to my buddy Ted Sikora, thank you for reminding me the thrill and excitement of taking a chance on the unknown. All right, Victory Seekers, it's time for me to get ready to head off to Detroit for Michigan Comic Con, a show that I've also never done before. I'm excited to see how it'll all unfold, and I'll be sure to share my experiences with you on the next exciting episode of Onward with Onrie. To victory!